If a tree falls in a forest, does it make a sound? If you created an amazing report but didn't share it with anyone, did you really create it? I'm going to show you how easy it is to create a beautiful Power BI dashboard and share it with anyone in your organization. Keep watching. And at this point, either you can go online, powerbi.com, and say get data, or really what's most convenient is right from within Power BI desktop, you can click the publish button. And the first time it might ask you to sign in. And for here, I'm using a pro feature. You don't have to use that. Most likely you're just gonna see my workspace and it's perfectly fine to publish to that. I set up an area for class. I'm gonna publish that here. But for you, again, publishing in my workspace is just fine. So I'm gonna select that. And I had done this once in practice. So it's asking me if I wanna replace it. Yes, sure. And it should be done in a moment. And there we go, it's done. It also gives you a quick link, which you can just open it. I already have it open, so I'm not gonna bother with that. If I go to Power BI, and again, I logged in with the same account that I had used to publish it. So I'm here and I see my data set, which really represents my data model. So let's examine the elements here. What are we seeing here? So on this side, I see my data set, which I just published. So that represents my data model. And I see reports, and let's see what that looks like. So if I click on reports, I see the report that I just built. And for my data set, if I were to click on it, it actually launches a new report. It gives me that blank page and I can create a new report right within my browser. If you click on the ellipses next to it, it has a few other options. We're gonna talk a whole lot more about this later on. But for now, this is the data set. This is the report that we just uploaded, all the elements that we had built. And what we're gonna see now is how to pin items on the dashboard. So we got a report, and a report is a rich, detailed view. Of course, you custom build it. You can have additional tabs. It's fully interactive. People can say, hey, go look at bikes, or drill down to accessories, all of this sort of stuff. But dashboard is a high-level view. Dashboard is that quick picture. Maybe you're building this for an executive, and on the move, they can just glance at it and say, hey, how are things going overall? Right. So that's what dashboard is. So reports, rich, interactive, detailed dashboards, kind of a high level view. And the way you start building off dashboards, so right now it's just totally blank. So the report was published, but we have to build the dashboard on powerbi.com on the cloud. And the way you go about building it is that you pin elements to the dashboard. So as you hover over the elements in your report, you would see this thumbtack. And all you have to do, this one is tricky, is just click on that pin visual, and it says, hey, which dashboard do you want to pin to, existing, or you can create a new dashboard. And I'm just going to choose existing and say pin, done. So let me go back and show you what happened there. Dashboard has this one element. And I'm going to pin a whole bunch of other elements, and then we'll go back and tweak our dashboard. So I'm going to pin sales, great. And I'm going to skip budget because I don't think that information is needed at a high level. So I'm just going to show variance and variance percentage, perfect. And then I'll choose these graphs. I believe these illuminate a whole lot more. All right, so I think I have the high level elements that I need. Now, if I go to my dashboard, it doesn't really look very impressive, but it's really easy to kind of change, resize, move things around. So I'm going to resize this tile here. And it resizes to a grid. So notice I can either make it this big or this big. There's really nothing in between. And trust me, that works for your benefit. It looks good in the end. And the best part, it lays out beautifully on mobile. So AdventureWorks, and I'll say sales, variance, variance percentage, and variance by month. And this one, I'm just gonna make it smaller. I don't think I need that much real estate. So this is a dashboard, kind of a high level dashboard, and you can share this with somebody. You can just type in their name if they're within your organization and they have signed up for Power BI. Usually the name just pops up, or just type in an email address. And you're ready. You're ready to go. You have done the three steps. Let's go back here. You authored a data model, you published it in the cloud, and now your Power BI dashboards and reports are ready for consumption. Now, there's a whole lot more to this, and we're gonna dive deep into it. All of these aspects about publishing, different options, dashboard reports, analyze and Excel, all sorts of fun stuff. That's coming later, but for now, I want you to give yourself a pat on the back. Really bask in the glory of what you have just done. I mean, trust me, this is magical. Maybe you didn't feel that way, but it would if you compare it to the old way of doing things. Now, I have worked in BI data analysis for a long time. This whole process, this would be three teams. There would be a team building the data model, and it doesn't matter the technology, SQL, SSIS, SSAS, or some other thing, right? Who cares? But this would be a team of people. This would be a team of people who would be involved about publishing it, maintaining the refresh, all of that sort of stuff. And there would be a team of people building the final end report. And you know what? Actually, no, it's not three teams, it's four. Because there would be another team kind of overarching all of this. Ooh, project managing the whole thing, right? I mean, there's so many moving pieces and all of these things, thingamajigs. Yeah, you need somebody to oversee all of it. And it takes too long, and anybody who's been involved in that process knows how, you know, you go to one meeting after the next. It's not a fun process. So what used to be four teams is now one person. You. That's the power you hold, my friend. And hey, with great power comes great responsibility. So handle this power with care. Use it for good, not for evil. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.